back, relax, and I hope you enjoy. Much love to all.
Boromu is Lord of Dryness and Desiccation. Although this is his essence and he is responsible for those conditions, he is also petitioned for relief and alleviation. Boromu spends time at the court of Olakun, Spirit of the Sea, and so is well acquainted with the powers of water. Boromu is little known in the Western Hemisphere. He is the Orisha of the desert, which may be why he does not seem to have survived the middle passage from Africa, home of the Sahara and Sahel, to the Caribbean or Brazil, Western Hemisphere strongholds of Yoruba spiritual traditions. Boromu is not exactly a spirit of death, but he is a spirit of not life. Boromu has dominion over dry bones and skeletons. Desiccated corpses or mummies presumably come under his dominion, too. He transmits the withering effects associated with the evil eye. Boromu rules contraceptives, abortifacients, and botanicals that eliminate or minimize chances of pregnancy. He may be the Orisha who administered an herbal potion to Yiwa, causing her to abort her illegitimate child. He has a very complex relationship with her and is sometimes described as her spouse or messenger. Boromu is traditionally venerated in conjunction with Yiwa and Orolakun. If you love the desert, you may be under his patronage, as are those who work with bones. In the face of floods or excess moisture, he may be helpful. Boromu is the master of herbal contraceptives and may be petitioned for information and assistance. He may also be beneficial in cases of severely dry eczema, psoriasis, or other skin disorders. Manifestation. Boromu's sand-colored robes mimic the rippling motion of sand dunes.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.